Synchronized head bobbing, a KISS innovation. It never appeared in rock and roll before KISS started doing it. Welcome to the show. It is the Friday night Power Trio show, minus, once again, the third member of the Power Trio, only this time it's Blake Wally. But Blake may join us a little bit later. He said he might be here in a few minutes, so we'll see if he comes
then
in.
Then we can get the head bobbing.
Bring him in, and we will get his opinions on the top, and Blake will come in and head bob a little bit for us. I don't have that hair. I wish I had that hair mop Paul Stanley has, although obviously they're wigs, quite obviously. I wonder how long they've been wigs, Brooks. How long do you think KISS has been wearing wigs as opposed to their real hair?
I have no idea. But I stopped dancing myself when I cut my hair.
Oh, well, of course you have to, because you know Paul Stanley ended up with two hip replacements, I think. So he's in bad shape. He's in bad shape for all that dancing around in platform shoes and jumping up and down. It's pretty funny stuff. All right, guys, welcome to the show. It's a little bit early. It's an hour early tonight, and it's going to be a short one because I have to head down to the Strip. And I have, do I have a date? I don't have a date, but I'm going to hang out with some friends that are in town. I've got more friends coming in town, but we cared enough about you that we had to do the show. Why is that, Dr. Brooks Agnew? Well, first of all, it's because we love our friends. We love our friends here that join us on the show. Secondly, it's because we had something momentous happen. And I think we talked about, if I remember, we talked about on Friday, we discussed how, you know, there were three or four things that I thought this is the way it would go, that Biden would be removed, Kamala Harris would be disqualified, McCarthy would be hit with the motion to vacate, and then Manchin or Sinema would switch parties, and Chuck Grassley would become the president pro tempore of the Senate, would become the interim president while we transition. Now, it didn't happen that way, and it didn't happen like on one day. I thought, boom, you know, because of the Q post, boom, 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 four booms. I thought maybe it's going to happen that way. Instead, what we got is we got one of the four, which is the motion to vacate. And that is an extraordinary thing. I keep telling people, I'm pissed off. I read some of the tweets from people. I read these some dumb Desiree Gershon Hergovitz or whatever the fuck your name is on Facebook. You're no longer my friend. Oh, I can't wait until he's gone talking about Trump and I'll never speak his name again. Fine. Get the fuck out of the country, okay? We don't need you. We don't want you in America, you stupid twat. Am I on a roll here? Yes, I am. I shouldn't have used that word. It's too bad. I already did. So fuck it. So... But Brooks, this is extraordinary because this has never happened. I don't think it's happened since 1910. It's not the kind of thing that happens in get along in Washington, D.C. Washington, D.C. is the way it is. And the vitriol against Matt Gaetz for actually proposing this and getting, you know, 8 Republicans to vote with 209 Democrats is pretty incredible. I'm going to read through some of that stuff on Twitter in a minute because I have a second point to make. So I just want to get your impression, Brooks. I'm kind of excited because this is the first time I feel like the deep state has really been dealt a blow, and maybe, just maybe, the dirty prosecutors and dirty judges and dirty congressmen and dirty senators and dirty president, fake president, stole the election. Maybe they're on notice for the first time that they may not get away with it. What do you think?
Yeah, because, I mean, the evidence is there, and it's just piling up every single day. All they really lack is dotting I's and crossing T's, but the main sentences are there. We know that the Bidens took over $50 million in bribes. We know that those bribes turned into policies, which weren't in America's best interest. They were in their customers' best interest in foreign countries. So it's just a matter of time. And what was happening is McCarthy had basically done a Paul Ryan. He bobbed his head. You know, he did the synchronized bobbing with the Democrats. And he said he was going to do all these wonderful things. And when it came right down to it, he put the omnibus through. He did one thing after another, just like Paul Ryan did. And Gates said, that's it. 9 months of our Congress is gone. And we haven't got anything done that you said you were going to do. So we're going to vacate the chair or vacate the seat. And when they did that, of course, what came back in was the nomination for President Trump. And then President Trump said, well, I think I would actually entertain that, you know, to the end of the year, maybe 90 days or so to get this Congress finished. And today he talked about 7 things that he would get done if, of course, he gets back in the White House. But a lot of these things he could get done as Speaker of the House. And then Jim Jordan came out and said, look, if President Trump wants to be Speaker, I'll move out of the way. More power to him. I want him to be President, but if he wants to be Speaker, that's fine with me. Then President Trump turned around and endorsed Jim Jordan. Now, honestly, I think Jim Jordan is a wonderful guy. I think he's spot on everything. He has all the right answers. He knows all the research. He has all the right comebacks when it's his turn to speak and when he chairs the meetings. But he's little more than a barking poodle. Bark, 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 bark. Wonderful barking. We like to hear it, but nothing gets done. Nothing gets done. Nobody gets to jail. No payroll stops, nothing. Mm-hmm. So I think the most important thing that can happen between now and the end of the year is the prosecution of the impeachment of Joe Biden. Number one. It's number one priority. It's got to happen. Will it happen under Jim Jordan? I doubt it. I think if there's too much politician in him.
I hate to say that I think you're right. I'm hoping that if he does end up being Speaker, that he will have to actually do something this time. He'll actually have to do something for a change, as opposed to doing nothing. You're right. He has done nothing but talk about, and let's bring in the third member of the power trio, TV's Blake Wall. He wasn't quite ready, but I got him in anyway. Hey, Blake, how you doing, man?
Good. How are we doing? Great to be here. Sorry I'm late.
Yes, Blake has the hair to do the synchronized head bob. We had to go with the KISS video again because I didn't download any other videos. So that's the only one I've got on my desktop. I gotta get another video for our opening Friday night. Anyway, No, Paul, just to correct you, Paul, Kamala Harris is not the president pro tempore of the Senate. Patty Murray is, as long as the Democrats hold a majority. And for Dianne Feinstein dead and the seat vacated, I don't think they hold a majority. I'm going to get into that in a little bit.
How about that Adolf Newsom picking the woman that lives in Washington, D.C. as a senator for California?
Another thing. And Kamala Harris is the president of the Senate, not the president pro tempore of the Senate, who is actually the fourth in line of the presidency. Because she's also the vice president who stands. It's parliamentary crap. So, Blake, I just want to bring you into this whole thing. What did you think about McCarthy? Actually, thank you, Blake. It's weird that Blake can actually change things on the screen while we're doing the show. Right. We share the account. Anyway, Blake, what did you think about McCarthy? Because what I was saying is, I feel like for the first time in ever, this is a shot across the bow to the corrupt judges and congressmen and prosecutors that are owned by Soros and politicians and even the fraud president we have in the White House that, hey, guess what? Stuff can happen to you. Do you think that it's that significant, or is this just a shot in the dark that, you know, happened? I think it means something. I don't know. Do you think it means something?
Oh, I think it's absolutely significant that this happened. They put him on, 15 votes, had him on a tight leash. He had an agreement in place, and he didn't do what he was supposed to do. He, you know, tried to give him the benefit of the doubt. You know, we didn't really trust him from the beginning. He's done some good things, but there's a lot of issues. Of course, the J6 footage that he did not release.
Right.
Of course, keeps sneaking all of our money into Ukraine. That wasn't sitting well. So it's time for more of a Trump conservative and not just the lifelong uniparty swamp creature. So it does send a message. And now he's going to be gone. And then people are trying to float Donald Trump. And maybe they're going to try to meet us halfway and give us Jim Jordan. Maybe that should be an upgrade. And then we'll hold his feet to the fire. But we have a different agenda in mind.
Yeah,
it's a disconnect. And it's time for they start working for us and not themselves.
Exactly. And do you worry about Jim Jordan's track record of talking a lot and not doing anything? Like Brooks went on an excellent summation of that right before you got here.
Yeah, definitely. There's a certain, I think with big tech or Google, there's been some times where he's let us down. So we'll definitely have to hold him accountable. So I think it looks like an upgrade for the time being, but we shall see. And we don't have the patience. So it's going to have to make something happen quick.
Yeah.
I
agree with you. Okay. So let's run the other idea, which is that, my thing was always, and I've got this on my Twitter, it's my pinned tweet, you know, this could all happen in a matter of hours, which is Biden removed, Harris is qualified, McCarthy motion to vacate, Manchin or Sinema switches parties, Chuck Grassley is the president pro tempore. The Senate, which Jen has predicted that he's going to be the president, interim president. And then the whole scenario comes true. Now, four things have to happen, obviously. Two of them have been talked about. Manchin has been talked about as switching parties. There's articles around there that there's rumors that rumblings that he might switch parties. Sinema has already declared herself independent, although she's caucusing with the Democrats, which is the only reason the Democrats are considered to still have a tie or a majority in the Senate right now. If either one of them, that's been talked about, and then motion to vacate was talked about, and one of them, the motion to vacate's actually happened. So the other alternative to get Trump back is that he becomes Speaker of the House and Biden and Harris are impeached or whatever is used. How realistic do you think that possibility is? Let's start with you, Brooks, and give Blake a chance to get his thoughts together. How realistic do you think that possibility is?
Well, I think it's realistic. And I also agree with one of your chatters, V-Read 954.
Yeah.
I think Jim Jordan will have Donald Trump in his ear. And I think he's going to be working very closely with him. But there's other pressures, too, coming from the states. Okay, Alaska is going to kick back against Joe Biden reneging those oil leases. Alaska is going to tell the federal government to get screwed. They're going to pump the oil where they want, sell it to who they want. And if they don't like it, they can send the federal troops up to Alaska. Texas has already kicked back. They're leaving the buoys where they are in the middle of the river. And they're using private contractors to erect the wall with their own money. And the third thing is, and I just came from there, Baker City, Oregon, a big rally for 13 counties in Oregon that wish to leave and become part of Idaho. This is a major deal because three congressmen go with them. 380,000 Oregonians will change their license plates and driver's licenses to Idaho. Idaho's population will go up by 24%, and 62% of the land of Oregon will leave. This is a very big deal, and it sets a precedent, and it encourages other states to take action against these Marxists as well. So there's lots of pressure on lots of levels, and it's all aimed at the Biden White House.
Okay, Blake, what do you think about the possibility of Trump becoming Speaker of the House and then impeaching? I mean, what Jen said today is if he does that, it's going to look like, you know, it is going to look like a coup. It's going to look like he used the powers, but it would all be legal, but it wouldn't look that good for him. What do you think about him, the possibility of him becoming Speaker and removing Biden and Harris for treason?
Yeah, the ball's in his court now. That's what's so amazing about this, because I didn't realize that. Or it's, you know, it sounds like fantasy, But here it is. It's all like actually lined up and happening.
The Speaker of the House does not have to be a member of the House. I could be Speaker of the House. Brooks could. You could be Speaker of the House. And I would support that, by the way.
I think it's better because then you don't have a dog in the fight. You don't have to worry about reelection. You're not swayed by special interest groups and how much money you can raise for one party or the other. And that's basically who becomes Speaker, the person that raises the most money.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, go ahead.
It's wild that that can actually happen. They can speculate, but it's legitimate. And he could technically become Speaker. It's never happened before, but why not this time? I can't think of really a good reason why not. And yes, and Biden's already got embroiled in enough corruption. They would absolutely destroy Trump if it was the opposite way around. So Trump has the power perhaps to get the 25th Amendment or to get Biden impeached for all the corruption. And then if Kamala's rendered ineligible, or probably if Biden goes down, she's probably going to go down. So it would just be an epic shit show. I'm here for it. It'd be the news cycle of a lifetime. And I didn't know that about Idaho. I do know that about Idaho, but it'd be interesting once they go through with it, you might see other states follow suit in something similar.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Our 12 counties have already passed it in their House and Senate. And we have one more. We'll make 13. And that's a very auspicious number. 13 states, 13 stripes, 13 counties. I'm telling you, the momentum is there. These people are tired of being slaves of Portland and Salem. Sick and tired of it. They feel just like the states did in the South when the states in the North put all those confiscatory taxes against them. They're out of there. Yep. Idaho is for it. The federal government's for it. All we got to do is pressure Portland and Salem, because all three conditions have to be met according to the Constitution for a switch to be made. But they got a lot of pressure. They got a lot of money.
You know, the eastern part of Washington, east of the Cascade, should also secede from Washington and join Idaho. Sure. That would make a pretty good super state. It would be one of the super states of the West. It would be probably they'd get close to 10 electoral votes. So it would become very significant.
Yeah, Oregon has 21, so they would lose 3, knocking them to 18, and Idaho would pick those up. And Idaho's all for it. And Idaho, I don't know if you know anything about the state, but it's a refugee camp. It's a refugee camp for conservatives that have left the West Coast.
Yeah.
And they brought their money with them, and they brought their conservative values with them. Idaho is very powerful.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. We're a little off the subject that I wanted to focus on with Idaho, but it's nice to get the update. Brooks? Okay, so let's talk about the reaction. The reaction to Kevin McCarthy being vacated out of the speakership, I think, has been exquisite. And some of it has been disappointing. There are some people who we always kind of knew who they were. We kind of knew who Mark Levin really was.
Oh, my gosh.
And he's made an absolute clown show out of himself.
No doubt about it.
Complete joke. Whitley Strieber today just... Talk about disappointing. Whitley, you can't really be this out of touch. The coup in the House was backed by Putin supporter Donald Trump. It is very much about defunding support for Ukraine. Good. That's what fucking needs to happen, Whitley, because Ukraine is the most corrupt country on earth. I don't think the American people want that. Yes, we do, Whitley. When will we stop flirting with political extremes and ruining our country? We're not ruining our country. We're fixing our country. Good God, guys. I love Whitley Strieber. I have a lot of respect for him. But if that's the shit the aliens are filling his head with, please get back in touch with reality, Whit, because you're totally out. Get out of New York. Get out of LA. Start talking to people in Idaho. Start talking to people in Nebraska. Am I wrong, guys? I mean, you know, I just... No,
you're absolutely right. And you know, these states bringing pressure against the federal government, they can't fight them all. States are tremendously powerful. They have a lot of power. They have a lot of rights according to the Constitution that the federal government, that the Constitution gives them against the federal government. Yeah. And they're starting to apply it.
They should have more. They should have more strength. And then let's look at some other examples. One of my favorite guys there is DC Drano. He's one of my favorite guys. He said, the fact that Hillary Clinton is mad Kevin McCarthy is no longer speaker only reaffirms. Oh, shit. I keep forgetting. I have to
got the right enemies.
Yeah, the fact that Hillary Clinton is mad Kevin McCarthy is no longer speaker only reaffirms that it's a good thing Kevin McCarthy is no longer speaker. Gunther Eagleman said, "It's amazing watching some of our GOP cry on interviews about Matt Gaetz holding Kevin McCarthy accountable. Remember, Kevin agrees to the terms when he was elected speaker. It's nobody's fault but McCarthy's. Good riddance." They're talking about how he's thinking about resigning. Fine, let it go. And isn't that the main thing, guys? Isn't that really the main issue here, that really Kevin McCarthy was held accountable, and that's what scares them, and that's what gives me a little bit of hope. Am I wrong?
No, you're absolutely correct, and that's what I wanted to have happen to Paul Ryan when he was started. You know, he would come to the cameras and he would say, "Oh yeah, we're gonna repeal Obamacare, we're gonna put this and that, and it'll all be done within a year." Nothing was done. Paul Ryan was a puppet, a Pelosi puppet.
Yep.
And I tried to tell President Trump, "You got to get rid of this guy. Don't let him be Speaker of the House." But he absolutely ruined the first 2 years of the Trump presidency.
Yeah, well, and now he's ruining Fox News as well as a member of their board. Yeah, Virginia, you know what? Go to his Twitter and respond to him politely. I was a little impolite, but politely respond to him and explain to him why he's got his head up his ass and to get with it. Because if the aliens are feeding him with that kind of shit, remember, I've told stories before about how Reagan got into politics. And what happened was aliens told him to. Okay, that's going to tell you that's the story, right? Through Shirley MacLaine, that is the story. Someday I will tell you the entire story on the show. But there are aliens that are basically Democrats and they're evil, and there are aliens that are basically conservatives that are good. And there's a war going on. And Whitley, the aliens you're talking to are feeding you with a bunch of shit. Blake, what do you think about the reaction? So many Republicans, I'm not sure about Ann Coulter. Did Ann Coulter say something? I don't know about her. Not that anybody cares about
Newt Gingrich.
Yeah, Gingrich, Levin.
I just called her Tranny Annie. Come on, that's a great nickname. Not that anybody cares about Tranny Annie anymore. But yeah, also Newt Gingrich ended his political career. "Oh, this can't happen." Well, yes, it fucking can, Newt, because it's in the fucking Constitution and the House rules.
Ask Louis Gohmert, man.
He lost. Yeah. He's
the first guy that brought it up.
And the thing is, guys, is that it's, again, they are screaming because they've been held accountable, right? Right,
yeah.
Blake? I mean, yeah.
Yeah, because this is how it's supposed to be run, or this is kind of the ideal version that we're trying to move towards. But they're so used to this culture for decades of just breaking promises. Like, it's just normal for them. And people just go, "Oh, it's just business as usual in Washington." Well, we're tired. We've reached the end of the rope here with the border and the country crumbling and the war in Ukraine and the J6 stuff and all the woke garbage. We can't take it anymore. So we finally got the House. And it's time to do something with it. And if McCarthy, we gave him a long leash, we were pretty nice and pleasant, and he didn't. So he failed. He's out. It's weird seeing these people screaming. Yeah, Liz Cheney and Kinzinger and, yeah, the other who's who. So, but you see who their true colors are. Even though they talk a good game, Levin and Gingrich on Fox. But, yeah, they're still loyal to that old guard party. So,
yeah,
time for fresh blood.
Rick, this is the thing that's the most disappointing about Whitley, who's part of my community, the UFO community, is that he should know better. He's not dumb. He's a very brilliant guy, but he's so brainwashed about left, right, Republican, Democrat. I mean, this is chaos. He doesn't want chaos. He doesn't want, I do. I want chaos. That's how we change things, is we destroy the old and replace it with something new and better. You know what that's going to be, Whit? It's going to be MAGA, okay? Which means people are going to be put first again in this country the way they're supposed to be. And it's like, oh, this is chaos, Whitley, but you were fine when a fraud pedophile and the colluded with the intelligence communities to steal the 2020 election, which anybody with a brain knows Donald Trump won in a massive landslide. That's not chaos. Yeah, that's chaos. When Hillary Clinton comes out and says, get this, fuck this fucking fuck, I hate her guts. Let's just listen to what this horrible, awful witch said here. Let's listen to Hillary here. Let's just
very, very, very strong partisans in both parties in the past. And we had very bitter battles over all kinds of things, gun control and climate change and the economy and taxes. But there wasn't this little tail of extremism waving, you know, wagging the dog of the Republican Party as it is today. Mm-hmm. And sadly, so many of those extremists, those MAGA extremists, take their marching orders from Donald Trump, who has no credibility left by any measure. He's only in it for himself. He's now defending himself in civil actions and criminal actions. And when do they break with him? You know, because at some point, you know, maybe there needs to be a formal deprogramming of the cult members, but something needs to happen. And how do you very
okay? So there she is proposing that we all be electroshock therapy or brainwashed or something like that. If that doesn't demonstrate what a horrible cunt you are, Hillary, and how much you deserve to have your face carved off like you did to that little girl, you bitch, that does. Sorry, I'm getting a little extreme today. Hey, Hillary, you deserve to assume room temperature if you haven't already. I don't buy that this is a body double, all that crap that I keep hearing all the time. Sorry, I got a little extreme there, but this evil witch needs to leave the planet Earth.
Settle down.
Yeah. Well, especially
grab this.
That's it. Yeah,
maybe she can make a case if she's we have to see the Anthony Weiner laptop and then we can put those
that's rumors. Right.
We'll find out one way or another. Well, but either way,
Podesta's laptop and Weiner's laptop and Awan's laptop and Biden's laptop. What, these don't exist anymore? All the evidence is there for crying out loud.
Yeah. Yep. Coulter said that Trump won't win in 2020. Well, you know, okay. Ann says a lot of things, very few of which are true. Thank you for chiming in, Tranny Annie. Hillary Clinton is literally Satan. She's literally the worst person on the planet Earth that I can think of. Maybe Klaus Schwab is worse, but Hillary is pretty bad. But they're coming for us. Isn't that what this is? This interview being done 2 days after we finally punched them back in the nose and took out their get along loser McCarthy. They do this, and guess what else they did? Now Biden says he wants to build a wall on the southern border after, of course, he's let tens of millions of illegals in, all of whom are going to vote Democrat in the fake election coming up in 2024. But don't you see these as a reaction to what happened with McCarthy? Isn't that what Hillary's out doing?
Yeah.
Trying to do damage control, Blake?
Yeah, it looks like it. Yeah, they're completely freaking out. But it's funny because now the mask is off and you see her for what she really is.
Sure.
Yeah, and she's probably into some really dark, twisted stuff. She is a witch of some kind. But yeah, we'll get to that later. The point is, what's in front of us right now is that they are trying to target their political enemies and they're calling MAGA extremists when they're anything but. They're just classic Americana. We love our Constitution and our Bill of Rights. They hate that stuff. She's a globalist. They want to get rid of the Bill of Rights, and they want to take us out. They want to get rid of freedom of speech. They want to shut us off, get rid of the show or what have you, get rid of all alternative media, take away people's guns, get rid of the Fourth Amendment, and have everybody just on some kind of technocratic dystopian plantation. Yeah, these people are sick. And she's calling for re-education. No, it's so anti-American. This is something that you would see if she was a communist country or something that we're making fun of.
It's pure Stalinism. I mean, the Nazis didn't even do this. The Nazis they basically just said, this is our position, take it or leave it, right? But it was Stalin, you know, Stalin had to force his ideas on people, and it's exactly what she's calling for. And, you know, did I get too extreme there? No, I actually don't think so. I'm going to delete it off YouTube anyway. So, you know.
Yeah. Until we get the Anthony Weiner laptop and the Hunter laptop and everything else and get all this information to light and whatever was in the WikiLeaks, there's so much information that's
I will only say that I have heard from someone who knows someone who has seen the laptop who said all that stuff is true.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's what I've been told. That's may or may not be true, but I have been told that's all those stories we've heard are true. That does not come from a person who has seen the laptop. It comes from a person who has talked to a person who has seen the laptop, which, by the way, they seem to keep dying all the time. They keep, didn't we lose another one of them? Okay, so there's all that stuff. Then something else happened, which is kind of an interesting cultural thing. Aaron Rodgers, quarterback for the New York Jets, formerly quarterback for the Green Bay Packers, was being interviewed. And, of course, Aaron Rodgers is a target because he took this product, which, Brooks, you may know something about, to get over COVID last year when he was playing football and got over it and was not allowed to play, even though he said, I feel fine. I took ivermectin. I'm cured. I don't have any symptoms. I want to play this weekend, and the NFL wouldn't allow him to. But then Travis Kelce comes along. Travis Kelce is a future Hall of Famer tight end. Let's just say he is, because he is. And he started to date Taylor Swift. And then after he dates Taylor Swift, he comes out and does commercials for Johnson & Johnson or Pfizer or something. Let's go sample and listen to what Aaron Rodgers had to say about Travis Kelce, the tight end for the Kansas City Chiefs here real quick. This is pretty damned amusing. Here we go.
Crazy impact game. Obviously, he had, you know, some yards and stuff, but I felt like for the most part, you know, we played really tough on defense, especially the last three quarters, and didn't have a crazy game. And, you know, Mr. Pfizer, we kind of shut him down a little bit.
So he was talking about the Jets Chiefs Monday night game last week, where the referees, just as they did in the Super Bowl, stepped in and assured that the Chiefs would win the game as opposed to the Jets. Vegas must have had some money on that. He called him Mr. Pfizer, which I thought was pretty damn. And of course, Kelce responded, I stand by protecting my family and my teammates by taking the vaccine. We don't even know if he took the vaccine or the same vaccine that people were given that it's been killing. Brooks, what do you think about Mr. Pfizer? And what do you think about Aaron Rodgers calling him out? I like it.
Well, I think it's wonderful. And, somebody we were talking just the other day about, you know, pulling the drug ads off of TV. You know, ask your doctor about this or that, you know, cure you and all the side effects, death and anal leakage and all that stuff. And, you know, if that happens, stop taking it. But ask your doctor.
You have to get anal leakage, yeah.
They should do away with that. And then I thought, oh, my gosh, if they do away with it, there's no more pro football, no more Fox News, you know. These drug ads are everywhere. The Pfizer logo is on the uniforms. It's on the helmets. It's on the shoes.
Pfizer is the number one sponsor of the NFL right now. It used to be car companies. Before that, it was beer companies and cigarette companies.
Yeah. It was motorcycles and cigarettes and cowboys. And that's what
all the things been like. Yep.
Football. But it's been drugs for decades.
Blake, what do you think about Aaron Rodgers calling out Travis Kelce as Mr. Pfizer? And Kelce had, I thought, a simpish, wimpy response today. Oh, I'm going to protect my family. Well, if you're going to protect your family, you don't get a vaccine that you can leak onto people.
Yeah, that's just like the PR talking points. No, I appreciate Aaron for going off script and telling it like it is. It's hilarious. And Travis Kelce may be a great tight end, maybe in the Hall of Fame, but he is a huge sellout for doing that. He's got more than enough money to, you know, not take any money from Big Pfizer or Big Pharma and Pfizer. And I think he was even pitching Bud Light, I've heard, too. So,
yeah.
He sold his soul. I don't know why, but...
That's what happens when you date Taylor Swift.
He's 34 years old, and so he's going to date Taylor Swift. He's got to be looking at life after football. I mean, so, you know, it can't go on forever. He's going to take a hit to the knee and blow it out, and that extra half step that he still has where he gets in front of people and gets away from people is going to go away, and his career is going to be over in about 6 months after that. So he's looking for his next thing after that. And, you know, he's already done reality TV and stuff. He did this dating show in 2014.
I would rather get a frontal lobotomy than date Taylor Swift.
Yeah, I know. She's not even cute. She's like, you know, past the wall. She's like 30. She's also 33 or 34. Like, Travis, you can get a younger girl than that. I'm just telling you right now. Anyway, but, you know, she's famous. So he's trying to become a celebrity husband or something, right? So I don't know. Do you guys feel like, there's any cultural shift going on here with this, or is this,
the pussification of football? Well, yeah, absolutely. It's a game show. It's, you know, get on the field, play football, and stop with all the silliness. I mean, this is just nutso. All the kneeling, all the politics, get that out. We just want to watch football.
Yep, I concur. I concur, absolutely. We want to watch football and we want to talk about football. We don't want some girl trying to talk to us about
it. Even if the Seahawks, you know, walk away with the game, I'm still watching.
Well, sorry about the Carolina game there, buddy. You know, I'm so torn because I love the Seattle Seahawks, but I hate Pete Carroll. I want Pete Carroll fired. So part of me is rooting for them to win. The other part of me is like, but if they lose, Pete Carroll might get fired. So I'm kind of like this, but it's great because I'm so emotionally even when I watch the games now, it doesn't affect me. They win, great. They lose, it's just great.
Normally, when the Panthers score 27 points, they win.
Yeah.
This time they lost.
But, you know, Seahawks got Kenneth Walker, who's a great running back, and Zach Charbonnet, who's another
Couldn't stop him.
DK Metcalf and, you know, and Tyler Lockett, who's criminally underrated. So they got a pretty good offense and they got some good offensive linemen. Finally, isn't it amazing how when Russell Wilson was here and he could run around, they didn't bother to spend any money on offensive linemen because, well, Russ can just run away from everything. And now he's gone. They actually went out and got some guys that can block. Stunning, isn't it? How that works. All right. A couple things just to let everybody know. I want to remind you, please, to visit our absolutely wonderful, wonderful, wonderful sponsors, the CBD Gurus, thecbdgurus.com, where you can get all kinds of cool CBD products for your health. Don't forget, you can go to the wholesale tab, slide down to Mike B Wholesale, type in the discount code, which is A-L-I-E-N, no capital A, no S on the end, and you can pick up a whole bunch of cool stuff that's on sale at the wholesale price. And if you spend $25, you get 10,000 Vietnamese dong and on and on and on up to orders over 150. You get 60,000 dong and 5 million Venezuelan Bolivar. Good for you. They got all kinds of cool stuff. The X-Freeze roll-on pain gel, my personal favorite. You put it on something, it stops hurting right away. It's awesome shiz. Let me just tell you, it's awesome stuff. Also, Dr. Brooks Agnew, why don't you tell us what is going on over at brooksagnew.blog?
Well, besides all the great upcoming events, main thing to pay attention to when you go to the website is right on the front. I put it right on the front page. You don't have to scroll anywhere.
Hey, wait a minute. I lost this. I lost
it. It says Ivan and Roxy without a prescription. Now, I hear all kinds of arguments, but I got to tell you, I am absolutely moved, touched by the emails and text messages I get from people who say ivermectin saved their lives or saved their dad's life or saved their mom's life or their grandmother's life. Over 25,000 people have this in their medicine cabinet now, thanks to this website. It's not enough. There needs to be more. We need to save a generation. Don't get the jab. Get immunized. These are the drugs that are doing it. Ivermectin and hydroxychloroquine. You can get it at cost in about 3 weeks.
Don't listen to Captain Pfizer. Listen to Dr. Brooks, okay? Get your IV, get your Ivan, get your Roxy, get these things in your arsenal to fight whatever they are planning next. And I think they absolutely are planning next. What else do you have over there in the health section that you want to talk about, Brooks?
Anything? Two great products. One is called True Niagen. It's if you just go down a little bit in the shop, you have to go up to there where it says store in the menu.
Store, shop,
Click on shop. And on the right-hand side is this website comes up, hopefully. Everything's working right.
It's not there. Okay.
Where it says health and safety on the right-hand side there at the bottom.
Yes,
health and safety. If you just scroll down just a little bit, you will see True Niagen. Now, True Niagen protects your telomeres. Telomeres are the tail end of your chromosomes. When those burn down, you die of starvation. It's called old age. Stop the old age. I haven't aged in 5 years because I've been taking True Niagen. It energizes me. I work my 40-year-old friends into the dirt. This is the greatest thing I've ever seen. It's all natural. It's made from milk, and it does the job. The next one is New Earth Regenesis. I had all my blood work done. I did this for 90 days, My blood numbers came in famously. My A1C dropped from 6.8 to 6.2, and my urine proteins, both albumins and the creatines, mm-hmm. dropped by 44% in 90 days. My doctor was amazed. This is shit. By the way, this website is the number one sale website in the world for New Earth Regenesis. Thank you so much for shopping with us. And by the way, I am personally grateful for all the people that came up to Mike at the Biomed Expo in Vegas, yep. and thanked him for getting ivermectin from this site. Thank you so much for your customers.
All right. And I'm gonna get blood work done in about 2 weeks for mm-hmm. Follow-up with my new doctor. And I'm gonna get that baseline, and then I'm gonna start all that stuff. And then we'll see what happens the next time I have blood work done. That'll be pretty exciting stuff. TV's Blake Wally, why don't you tell us what's going on over on your site, thenextlevelnews.com.
Well, I'm doing a show twice a week, Tuesday and Thursday, with my friend Brian Engelman of the New American Media. We run a show called the Agree to Disagree Show, all the hot button issues of the day and beyond. So, if people want to go check out the show and support it, that would be great. And, thank you all for your support. It's good fun. Fun and informative and entertaining, hopefully. So, check it out sometime.
.com. Wasn't Stephanie Jackson doing that show with you guys for a while?
She was. Yeah, a couple of months. Yeah, it was fun having her. I'm not sure if she's coming back or not. She needed to take a break and some time off, but maybe work her into the rotation again sometime.
Stephanie's a great girl. Like her a lot.
Yeah.
So, I'm glad she's.
Absolutely.
She's very cute, very sweet, very cute, very great. All right. Anything else you guys want to have a quick discussion about before we head out? I got to get down to the strip. I'm meeting somebody at the Wynn for a drink. What's up, Dr. Brooks Agnew? Anything you want to add that we didn't talk about here on this quick, short show we did today?
Well, not to give people financial advice, but it might be a good idea between now and Christmas to move some of your cash out of the bank and into a box at your house. Not saying all of it. I'm just saying you need to be liquid. Cash is king, and you might not be able to get to it if they start putting pressure on the banks.
Which hopefully they will start doing very soon. TV's Blake Wally, anything you would like to add that we didn't have a chance to talk about on this very short early Friday evening show?
I think we hit all the major issues. I guess I'll just follow. I think that's great advice from Brooks, and they're going to have banking announce their earnings next week. That could have some fireworks, or especially if they're going to have a bank holiday because they know the numbers are going to be bad. I don't think it's going to be anything that scary, but yeah, it's always good to have some cash on hand and probably some smaller denominations because not everybody's going to be able to make change. But also Bitcoin is really emerging also as a potential safe haven, if you will, if not gold and silver. So it's a good time to at least start researching into that stuff. Because
yeah, I think I don't have much gold. I have some silver though.
Silver's great, and it's easy to move. Yeah, easy to liquidate.
You can sell it in 5 minutes at a pawn shop.
Yep,
sounds good. All right. Okay. One last thing before we get out of here, guys. Any predictions for the week coming up? Brooks, got a prediction?
Well, I think that Jim Jordan is going to be sworn in as speaker, and I think that it's going to be a very close alliance between President Trump and Jim Jordan. And I don't know who's going to take over those committees, but I think the committees were a freaking waste of time anyway.
How about Matt Gaetz and actually getting something done? How about that? TV's Blake Wally, do you have a prediction for next week?
I'm going to go optimistic and I don't know, maybe Donald Trump to take over as speaker. Woo! I'm still hoping there's a way that can happen. Maybe Jim Jordan will just step out at the last second and then Donald Trump will take over. That would be great. I think the news cycle deserves it. America deserves it. Whether you like him or not, you're going to love the news cycle.
Blake goes big. We love that, Blake. Okay, I'm going to make a prediction. The speakership will not be filled on Wednesday. It will remain vacant. for a while longer.
I love it. No laws are written. We don't have a Congress.
Let me grow a pair and actually say it. The speakership will remain vacant until we convene here again next Friday. Same bad time, same bad channel.
No money to Ukraine for 7 days. Wow.
And Whitley, come on, wake up. By the way, I just like to say to anybody, if I offended you with any of my language today,
tough titty,
do that. They all deserved it. Hillary Clinton is a demon. She's Satan. So that's it. All right, guys, thanks for being here. I got to run. Loved that you guys came in and helped me do the show early. That is the best. Happy October 6th to all of you. It's getting into spooky season. Start thinking about what you're going to be for Halloween. I already have my costume. Cool. As soon as you walk around, I'm going to walk around the strip. I'm gonna have a whole plastic bag full of cocktail olives and stick them on the end. And you walk around and stick them up into a girl, and then they all like take them in. It's fun. Yeah, it's really fun. That's what I'm going to do for Halloween. Love you guys. Thanks for being here. We will see you again. I'll be back on Monday with Jen and the three of us, the Power Trio. We'll be back with a new opening video. Well, maybe not a new one, but a different opening video than Kiss for a change. Thanks for being here. We appreciate you all, and have a good night. Have a good Friday. Enjoy your weekend. See you later. Yeah.